Atlanta, how are you feeling? Matt Ryan advances to his first Super Bowl and becomes only the fourth player in NFL history to pass for four touchdowns and rush for another in a playoff game. Atlanta is only the seventh team to score at least 35 points in back-to-back playoff games within a single postseason during the Super Bowl era. So Ryan has arguably been the best quarterback all season. Let me tell you why. Finishing top three in completion percentage, top three in completion percentage, pass yards, and total touchdowns, he's second, and total QBR first. Sorry if that wasn't explained exactly right there, but you can see it on the full screen. Max, I want to start with you. Is Matt Ryan that good, or is he a product of the Falcons system?
Before I answer that, I want to say Matt Ryan is excellent. He's excellent. But obviously, he's benefiting greatly, not only from the Falcons system, but from the personnel, which is extraordinary. And from the era in which he's playing, and from the fact that he gets to play indoors on a fast track with all that talent in that system. Matt Ryan is, again, he's excellent. Maybe he'll be great, but he's more Kurt Warner than, say, Peyton Manning in his prime. And Kurt Warner was recognized as the best player in the world for a couple of years. But Kurt Warner also benefited from, he was an excellent, I would say great quarterback, who benefited from an explosive offensive era, an explosive offensive system, explosive offensive players all around him. And that's what Matt Ryan is. I would call him Kurt Warner light. I think Kurt Warner at his best, probably better than this version of Matt Ryan, who's an excellent quarterback with weapons everywhere he looks, on a spread out offense, five receivers beating their man constantly, running backs who can catch and run the whole thing. He is obviously benefiting from that and being made to look, apologies to Matt Ryan, probably a little better than he actually is.
I'm not flowing with that. And the reason why I'm not flowing with that and I'm not agreeing with you is because I see too many mediocre or less quarterbacks in the NFL with requisite weapons, and they just can't get it done. They're sorry. Case in point, Jay Cutler, the worst quarterback in the NFL because he's the most leaderless quarterback I've ever seen. And for those of you who have not seen a picture on him since he's been on his latest vacation, since he's no longer quarterbacking because it's the playoffs and he's allergic to the playoffs because he's never there, do you see how fat and sloppy he looks? I mean, it's just an embarrassment. This is the truth. Listen.
If your mother's watching.
Oh, my mother's watching?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll guard myself.
Thank you.
Jay Cutler looks rotund, out of shape,
slovenly,
and slovenly. Not quite Jabba the Hutt, but clearly somebody who looks clearly out of shape and not interested at all in looking like a professional. And don't get me started with his performance. Is that better? I hope so, Mama. I hope so. Now let me get back to my point. When you look at a Matt Ryan, I know that Julio Jones, you can just throw the ball up in there. Mohamed Sanu coming over from Cincinnati is a welcomed addition. Gabriel is no joke. Freeman and Coleman are no joke. But there's somebody leading the way. And I got to take a moment to give credit where credit is due, because when I look at a Matt Ryan, this guy was 1-4 in the playoffs coming into these playoffs. His QBR, his completion percentage, all of those things. This guy has thrown for over 4,000 yards in now what is six consecutive seasons. But once the postseason arrived, he didn't get it done. In 2008, 2010, 2011, first 3 years he was in the playoffs, never won a game. Won a game in the divisional playoffs in 2012, but ultimately lost to San Francisco in the NFC Championship game. This dude really didn't get much done. This year, we're looking at a guy completing 70% of his passes, 730 yards in two games. All right, I'm just looking at him right now. It's impressive. Seven touchdowns. We just finished talking about Big Ben Roethlisberger. Six touchdowns in his last seven games. Matt Ryan alone has seven touchdowns in these two playoff games. He is clearly big time. Even though he could be somewhat of a product, they're a product of him. Because if he couldn't throw the football the way that he's throwing the football, what would they be able to do?
Right.
He
is both the orchestrator and the beneficiary of the offense. And there's no question that he's excellent. He's obviously excellent. But is he the best player in the league? No. He might win the MVP this year, and the stats say he deserves it. Is he better than Aaron Rodgers? No. Is he better than Tom Brady? No. But he will put up MVP numbers because he is excellent and he is on a loaded offense on a fast track that favors the offense.
One point I want to say about you, you know, you religiously say stuff like that and you're not wrong, but I think it's important to know that there are plenty of people who win and are deserving of an MVP award for that particular mm-hmm. year, who ain't the best. Mm-hmm. They just had a more
MVP
caliber season without being
generally,
the best. Nobody will call Matt Ryan better than Tom Brady or Aaron Rodgers. But what we can say is you can make an argument that he's had a better year.
Generally, MVP,
this is the way it works differently in football than in basketball. In basketball, it tends to be that the less you have on your team, if you put up monster numbers, which will favor you putting up monster numbers because you're the one shooting the ball more, et cetera, James Harden, Russell Westbrook, you will be tended to favor, they'll tend to favor you in MVP. In football, it's the more weapons you have around you helps you put up monster numbers.
Well, you have to win. You have to have a good record as well. I guess it is different than in the NBA and what you're saying.
Matt Ryan is excellent, but speaking of basketball, he's like a point guard on a team with LeBron James and Kevin Durant and, like, all these weapons. Of course the point guard's going to average 15 assists or whatever it is.
Yeah, but usually they wouldn't be recognized for the MVP because you recognize the requisite parts around them. In this case, those guys wouldn't excel if it were not for him. The example that you're using, those guys could excel without a great point guard.
Steve Nash with the Phoenix Suns. Was he the best player in the league? He got the MVP. He put up monster numbers.
Different
he was
sport.
The orchestrator. He deserved credit, but he was also the beneficiary of D'Antoni's system and other excellent offensive players.
We'll leave it on that note.